Welcome back you all in today's class. This is Sween Gulati from Takshila Model Senior Secondary School. So, in today's class, we are going to learn past tense. Chapter 11, past tense. So, let's open your book, Chapter 11, past tense, and begin with me. Okay, students. In the previous class, we have studied about the present tense, right? So, we have studied about there are three tenses, present tense, past tense, future tense, right? So in previous class, we have studied about simple present tense. In today's class, we are going to learn about past tense, right? What is past tense? Simple past tense. It tells us about the actions that took place some time ago. It means it is referring to the time, it is referring to the action which was taken some time back. Means, koi action jo kuch time pehle hua tha. Right? So, is tense mein hum kiski baat karte hai? Jo action past mein hua tha, pehle hua tha, jo action ho chuka hai. Jo bhi work hamara, jo bhi action hai, jo bhi time period hai, jo beat chuka hai. Right? So, jo beat chuka hai, jo kuch time pehle hua tha. That is known as simple past tense. Right? That took place some time ago. It means that actions that took place some time ago. Right? It is a simple one. Anil gave me a pen. So here children, how will you identify whether it is present tense or past tense? So the difference, the main difference is that we will see the verb. Hum yahan pe forms of verbs check karenge. Right? Anil gave me a pen. So, this is the subject, this is the person, and then we use verb and then object, right? So, we have to check the verb. Ki hamara verb kaun sa use hua yahan pe. So, we have here used V2 form verb. It means past form of verb. V2 means past form of verb. Jab hamara verb, ab hame bolna hai, if the question is given, fill the blanks with the past form of verb. राइट या फिर आपको एक सेंटेंस गिवन है तो आपको कैसे आइडेंटिफाई होगा वर्ब को चेक करके अनिल गेव मी अ पेन राइट तो ये आपकी पास्ट फॉर्म है इसका व्हाट विल बी द प्रेजेंट फॉर्म ऑफ गिव गेव इज गिव गिव इज द फर्स्ट फॉर्म गेव इज द पास्ट फॉर्म गिव गेव गिवन राइट वी हैव थ्री फॉर्म्स ऑफ वर्ब गिव गेव गिवन सेकेंड Rohit sang a song. So what is verb here? Hame children mean we have to focus on the verb. Aapko verb se pata chal jayega ye aapka kaun sa tense hai. Right? Aapko verb se identify ho jayega whether it is present tense ya past tense. So aapko action dekhna hai ki aapka action kab hua tha? Present mein hua tha past mein. Right? So yahan pe verb ke through aapko identify hoga whether it is present tense. So here Rohit sang a song. So Rohit is subject and verb is sang. So, what is the first verb? Sing. Sing is the first form of verb and that is the V2 form. Second form means past form of verb. Okay? Now, we'll discuss this more about it. Okay, kids. So, here is an important note. We add D or ED to change some verbs into their past tense forms. So, kids, now, how we can change the main verb or the first form of verb into the past tense, right? So here is a note that we have to add D or ED. हमें कुछ verbs में D or ED add करके हम verbs को change कर सकते हैं, right? For example, dance, danced. So here we have added D. Push, pushed. We have added ED. There are many more examples. Call, called. Experience, experienced. Play, played, right? There are many more. Next, we come to the next point. Spelling of some words change when they change into the past. Now here, spellings gets changed, right? Spelling gets changed. So, some verbs change their spellings. There are few changes in the spelling of verbs, right? Ring, rang. Fly, flew. So here, spellings have been changed. You can see how the spelling I has been changed into A, right? Y has been changed into EW, right? Okay, if I say write, R-I-T-E, it will change into wrote, right? Drive, drove, sing, sang, drink, drank, eat, ate, right? Okay, next is some words change completely when they change into past, but some words are there which are totally changed, जो पूरे के पूरे change हो जाते हैं, वो कैसे change होते हैं, जैसे go, went, go का क्या होता है, went, totally change, right, पूरा word change, teach, taught, पूरा word change, except t, means t को consider नहीं, but पूरा almost word change, so this is how the forms of verb change, right, okay. So kids, one more important point to remember is that how to identify whether it is past tense. हम कैसे पहचानेंगे कि past tense में है, अगर आपको कुछ नहीं given question में कि ये past tense में fill करना है या फिर आपको identify करना है present या past में. So important, very important point to remember, whenever you will find the word last or yesterday, जहाँ भी आपको sentence में last या yesterday दिखे, so it is clear that we are talking about past tense. So इससे ये clear हो जाएगा कि यहाँ पे past tense की बात की जा रही है, right? So you can find the examples like last day, last week, last month, last year, right? So in the sentence you can find that I went to Delhi last week, I went to Delhi last year, I went to California last year, I cleared my exams of UPSSC, whatever, I cleared my exam last year, right? I was in grade 1 last year, I was in grade 2 last year, okay? Last night, I slept with my grandmother last night, he slept with his grandmother last night. So wherever you find the last word or you find the yesterday, like yesterday I went to Delhi with my father, yesterday my mother cooked delicious food, yesterday my sister fought with me. So this is very important point to remember, that whenever you find the last in yesterday, it means we are talking about past tense. Now let's do one exercise to make it more clear. Kids, let's do an exercise here. Fill in the blanks with the past form of verbs. So here is an exercise in which you have to fill the past forms of verbs, right? Okay, so the first sentence is my mother dashed tasty breakfast yesterday. So what is the main verb here? Cook. What will be the past form of cook? Cooked. Cook, cooked. Next, the car dashed suddenly. Stop, right? What will be the past form of stop? Stopped. E-D. Okay, next, Peter dashed slowly walk. Peter walked, ed form. Right? Next, we dashed many things from the fair. Buy, right? So here it is not buy it. We have to change, the word will completely change. The buy, bought. Past form is bought. We bought many things from the fair. It means we bought, buy means purchase karna, khareedna. So humne bahut sari cheeze fair se khareedi, right? Clear? Okay, now next we will do past continuous tense. Okay kids, now let's do past continuous tense, right? In the previous chapter we have done simple present tense and present continuous tense, same as in the past tense chapter we will study about past continuous tense, right? It is same as present continuous tense, right? When the action was going at the time, present time, that is present continuous. Now here, when the action was going on at some point of time in the past, that is past continuous tense, right? Past continuous tense. Children, by the name itself, you can identify that continuous means continue, going on, right? So come to the definition, past continuous tense. It is used to tell us about the action that was going on at some point of time in the past, right? So it is used to tell us about the action. It means it is telling about the action that was going on at some point of time in the past. At some point of time, right? Right? It is very important that it is going on at some point of time in the past. Remember this. When the action was in the past, it means past continuous tense, right? Going on at some point of time in the past. Now, next. We use was, were and adding ing to the main verb to change it into its past continuous, right? So, here children, we use was, were. In the previous chapter, we were using ismr plus ing. Now here, we will use was, were. This is the past form of verbs. Ye was, were kya hai hamari? Past form of verbs hai. Right? Jab hum past continuous ki baat karte to hum past form of verb lagayenge. Present ki baat hoti to hum present form of verb. Now, children, one more thing. Remember, when we add was, were and ing. Remember, where do we use was and where do we use well, children, you have already studied in the previous class and previous chapter even was. Was is used for when we talk about singular subject, right? Singular subject. And were is used when we talk about plural subject. Plural subject. Now, what is singular and plural? Means, when we talk about one person subject, one single name, we use was. When we talk about more than one, we use well. Now, come to the example. Tarun dash a kite. So, here Tarun is what? We are talking about one name, single name. So, what we are going to use? Was. Right? So, Tarun was. Simple. And then question, then the point says, add ing. So, here, now we have to add ing, but where? With the main verb. Right? They are saying add ing with the main verb. So, what is the main verb given here? Fly. Right? And then we have to add ing. Right? So, Tarun was flying a kite. It means Tarun kite uda raha tha. Patang uda raha tha. It means the action was going on in the past. Right? Ki is action ki baat jo hum kar rahe hain ki Tarun patang uda raha tha. ये एक्शन कॉन्टिन्यू था पास में अब है नहीं है वी डोंट नो बट उस टाइम पे तरुण वॉज फ्लाइंग अ काइट. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर मोर एग्जांपल्स विद यू लाइक रिया वॉज सिंगिंग अ सॉन्ग राइट ओके जिया वॉज डांसिंग इन द क्लास. नाउ दैट वॉज द सिंगुलर सब्जेक्ट. नाउ प्लूरल सब्जेक्ट चिल्ड्रन वर रीडिंग अ लेसन बच्चे लेसन रीड कर रहे थे. Right. Teachers were making a lesson plan. Teachers were making lesson plans. Teachers क्या कर रही थी? Lesson plan बना रही थी. So children, here I have used teachers were, children were, right? Doctors were treating the parents. Doctors. The dogs were barking at the strangers. Dogs. So we have used were, right? So you have to remember one more thing. Where do we use was and word, right? You have to pay attention to the subject. Okay? I hope this topic is clear to you and the whole chapter is clear to you. Right? Okay. Thank you.